Arkansas Governor Sarah Huckabee Sanders is still experiencing a flurry of criticism over the fact that last Friday, in anticipation for Monday's eclipse, which did go, obviously, path of totality was over Arkansas, but last Friday she declared a 14-day state of emergency for the state of Arkansas for a roughly 30-minute event. 2 weeks of emergency, just chaos, I guess, happening in Arkansas for a 30-minute event. So what was so horrible in Arkansas? Why was Sarah Huckabee Sanders panicked? Well, probably because for one of the first times in Arkansas history, people actually wanted to travel to the state. And I'm sorry to anybody watching from Arkansas. I'm not necessarily trying to insult your state, but let's be honest here. Arkansas is not really a tourist destination, okay? You don't pack up the family for 2 weeks in summer and say, hey kids, we're heading to Arkansas, right? I mean, let's be real about it. So Sarah Huckabee Sanders, expecting an influx of tourists, declares a 14-day state of emergency because, as she said in her declaration, you know, some of the trucks that deliver things, they could be delayed because of traffic. My God, do they not have traffic in Arkansas otherwise? I mean, admittedly, I've never been there, but I got to imagine that, okay, we're stuck in traffic for a little bit. Maybe we're delayed by an hour or two, but a 14-day state of emergency is a bit excessive. But it wasn't just a state of emergency. Oh God, no. The first term governor said this in her declaration. Out of an abundance of caution, I've directed funds to be released from the Response and Recovery Fund ahead of the Great American Eclipse. So you're not only sending your state into a panic because people were going to be there for a day, you're also using up state money meant for actual emergencies. I mean, Arkansas, like a lot of other states, is in Tornado Alley. Arkansas has natural disasters. Arkansas has crises that will emerge this year where they need that money. But instead, Sarah Huckabee Sanders says, well, we got to get the trucks to go through. So here's money, because the money from the state emergency fund is going to get the trucks through the traffic. That's a new one. I mean, she did say this will assist commercial carriers transporting essential items to customers in Arkansas during the eclipse. How? Like, if you've got a semi driver stuck in traffic because there's new people coming into the state for a couple days, how is money going to build a new road in 24 hours for that truck driver to get off? Like, that's, none of it makes any sense. And this is what happens when you put stupid people in charge of states. I mean, Sarah Huckabee Sanders is exhibit A of somebody who is in a position that she should not hold. She is not smart enough to hold it. She does not have the experience to hold it. Yet here she is draining state funds for a 30-minute eclipse. Ring of Fire founder and host of America's Lawyer, Mike Papantonio, has a new book called Suspicious Activity. Like his other books before it, this book actually deals with real legal cases that Mike Papantonio has handled, but in a fictionalized way. The book follows the character of Nick Dicotomis that Papantonio first introduced in his book Law and Disorder, and it carries on the story that began in Law and Disorder through Law and Vengeance, Law and Addiction, Inhuman Trafficking, and now Suspicious Activity. This book in particular deals with the financial institutions that have helped launder money for terrorist organizations, which of course is a topic we have covered extensively here on Ring of Fire. So, if you're a follower of Mike Papantonio's books, or if this is your first one, you can get your copy of Suspicious Activity now. Just go to MikePapantonio.com and place your order. And if you haven't already, check out Mike's other books, also available on MikePapantonio.com.